Hi there, I'm RabbitBen. I'll show you the build of Gauss Prime this time. This build makes it possible to fight through the survival mission on the steel pass for 1 hour without activating the capsule. This build is designed to fight like a samurai who controls the cold element. As for shooting weapons, use whatever you like. Let's take a look at the Gauss Prime build. For the enhancement items, I used an Orokin reactor, an Exilus adapter, and 5 former. I used 3 red and 2 purple Argon shells. 2 of the red pieces are used for the power of the abilities, and other for the duration. With the remaining 2 purple shells, let's boost the critical attack of the melee weapon, and make sure to port the abilities as well. This time, let's replace the first ability with Grendel's ability. Grendel's ability multiplies energy recovery. This will increase the amount of energy recovered by Gauss's original second ability. If you activate both abilities at the same time, you will have no energy problems at all. Once the Argon shells and abilities have been ported, let's install the mods. First, let's prepare mods and the arcane to ensure survivability. The aura mod should be Brief Respite, which restores shield when activating abilities. Next, put Prime Shield Footer in Exilus slot to remove the risk of running out of abilities. Adaptation and Rolling Guard further boost survivability, and Arcane Resistance provides poison protection. Adjust the usability of abilities with Primed Flow and Primed Continuity, Fleeting Experience, and Overextended. Then, ensure the power of abilities with Umbral Intensify and Mode Augmented. Finally, include an augmentation mod for Gauss's third ability, which can be available from the Pairing Sequence or Arbiters of Hexes. This augmentation mod will increase Gauss's firepower. Then, the build is now complete. Overall, the build prioritizes efficiency and range of abilities. Next, we will look at the build of Nikana for Gauss. This time, I'll use Nikana Prime, which is revived with Prime Resurgence along with Siren Prime. It is quite good because of its high critical and status chance. We used the Orokin Catalyst, Exilus Adapter, the Melee Arcane Adapter, and 3 former, and 1 Umbral former. First, use the Sacrificial mod to ensure critical hit. Next, I used Gladiator Might to increase the firepower, and also make it possible to get more critical hits. Next, I add 3 elemental mods and melee prowess to increase the chance of status effects to 100%. Then, use Healing Return to regenerate health. Elements are made viral with poison and cold and electricity. Thanks to these elements and melee influence, it is possible to spread the status effects. Finally, install the mod available in the C reward of Alchemy Mission, the 4th reward in the Exilus slot. Now, you can use Tenokai to launch heavy attacks comfortably. Now, the build is ready. Let's use it. As usual, let's make use of all abilities. First, activate the first and second abilities to ensure survivability and energy. Thanks to Grendel's ability, the energy recovery of the second ability is increased. Then, use the third ability to increase the battery gauge needed for Gauss by stopping the enemy on his way. The firepower of Gauss can also be increased by using the augmentation mod. Since you are using the third ability repeatedly, the enemies around you should be iced over, so you will be able to take them down easily. Hold down the melee attack button, and it will automatically attack and take down the enemy. Then, since you are putting the Tenkai in, launch the heavy melee attack when the mark appears. The third ability will save your gauge, so use the fourth ability to increase Gauss's capability. Rolling is a good way to avoid the rare attack that even Gauss's ability cannot block. Maintain the first, second, and fourth abilities. Hit the third ability repeatedly to keep the gauge up. Keep attacking with melee weapons, rolling when it becomes dangerous. If you take care of these 4 things, you will be able to fight for about 1 hour in the survival of the Steel Pass mission. If you have enough gauge, try pressing and holding the third ability and then shortly pressing it. It can suck the enemy in. This is an overview of Gauss Prime build. Thank you very much for watching. Since no shooting weapons are used in this build, there is a lot of potential for further growth and development. Please use your favorite weapons to make Gauss Prime even stronger. If you want more build, please subscribe to my channel. See you next time. Bye.